In this video I want to show how you can make an oscillator with a transformer to work. And generally spoken, these circuits, this circuit or this circuit, always works. But you can make some mistakes when you regard a circuit. And that's the reason why I want to explain that more specific. And that means also that I want to talk in more general terms about how such a circuit works. This is a circuit with a Darlington. One property from the Darlington is that it amplifies extremely. That means when you have a transformer here and you get that transformer into oscillation, the output from the waveform will be like this. Because of the extreme amplification, you'll see a waveform that has a square wave-like form, or perhaps somewhat another form. But the reason is that the voltage at the output from this oscillator is driven between approximately zero and the power supply voltage, and that's here between 1 and 12 volts. So it over amplifies, the amplification is very very strong, and that makes that you cannot tame the oscillation and have these kinds of waveforms. On the other hand, we have here a circuit with one transistor. It doesn't amplify so much. The wave form is tamed by the way the transistor is set to a certain working point. And that's very very important. When you look on the internet, this resistor here, I use a potentiometer, is often divided into two fixed value resistors, and that means that the circuit only works with those two separate resistors, but you cannot set the transistor to a certain working point. And with oscillators this is extremely important. So use a potentiometer here. In case of one transistor at 12 volts or so, 25k or 22k is very good. And when you have a Darlington, due to the very very high amplification, you need a higher value potentiometer to set the whole circuit to the right working point. So often I use 50k or 100k, perhaps even 220k. That works properly because of the extreme amplification from the Darlington. In an oscillator there's always a circuit with a primary circuit, and in some way the circuit must be fed back, sent back into the grid or into the base from the transistor or the tube to make the whole circuit oscillate. It's a feedback circuit. You need somewhere a device to feed the circle to, the energy, sorry, the signal back from the collector lead, in this case to the base. This can be a coil, and here it's also a coil. We know from a coil that when you add a capacitor parallel to a coil, the frequency goes down. Here we have the same principle. This is Cx. When you add, for instance, a 100 nanofarad capacitor to a coil, you will see that the frequency goes down compared to a 10 nanofarad capacitor or so. So how do we feed the signal back to make it oscillate? There is a phase difference between the signal here and the signal on the secondary. And the key to make it oscillate is the proper connection from the feedback coil. So when you, for instance, connect this part of the coil back to the base, or this part of the coil, that differs much. So you have to find out, often experimentally, what part of the coil must be coupled back to the base from the circuit. Exactly the same applies to this circuit. Also here, when you connect this part of the coil back here, the circuit does not oscillate, but when you